Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1757. Bubble chart, color each bubble. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Got a call from my friend Tony this week. He was trying to color each individual bubble in a bubble chart based on a column that he had out here. Well, bubble charts, they're kind of a strange animal in Excel because we have to use all three columns to communicate the X value, the Y value, and the size. And so when we look up here in the series formula, wherever we would normally store the label information, they have to store the size information. So it's an unusual type of chart to begin with. It's hard to label. Usually we have to go out and download the chart labeler add-in, but let's knock out a little bit of macro code here. So I said to Tony, I said, hey, you know, I'm at the grocery store right now, just try this. Turn on the macro recorder, call it how to color bubble, and select the chart. The first click on a bubble will select the entire series, and you can see this in the layout tab that we've selected series one. Then do a second click on one bubble to select that one point. And look up here in this dropdown to see how they label it. And I was hoping they were going to get the label from here, but of course they can't because they don't even know that these are the chart labels. Instead, they're numbering them based on the numbers here, which is really bad because you might have duplicates and you might have formulas here, which I do. I have random formulas. So these numbers are going to change all the time. There's no way that I can figure out the point name based on data in this column. Okay, so now we've selected that, and let's apply a color down here. I'm going to use one of the standard colors instead of the theme colors, and we will stop recording. Go look at that code. So Alt F8 and how to color a bubble. Click Edit. All right, so they activate the chart, select the first series. Oh, this is really good. So even though it was called 0.76 or whatever in quotes, they're actually just using index numbers here. So 0.1 through 0.10 corresponds to the rows, apparently. And then this is really why I recorded the macro. So we have the series, we have the point, and then we need dot format, dot fill, dot for color, dot RGB is equal to the actual color. So that is crazy. We're going to have ser dot points, and it'll be in a loop, dot format, dot fill, dot for color, dot RGB. That is a incredible string of properties there that I never would have been able to remember or figure out without the macro recorder. So the whole point of recording this macro was to get that one line of code right there. We select the series, select the points, and then dot format, dot fill, dot for color, dot RGB. I don't need this macro. I can actually delete the module because I have this line of code, and we'll use that line of code back here in the macro that I started. Now, some of this code I got from my book, Charts and Graphs for Excel 2010 or Excel 2013 or even Excel 2007. I have a chapter there on macros for charts. So I set up two object variables, chart and series. Set chart equal to the active chart after I activate it. And then series collection one, there's only one series. Figure out how many points we have. I'm going to add labels. Even though Tony didn't want to add labels, I figured that this would be a good time to do this. And then we loop for I equals 1 to point count. Figure out the color from the sheet. So we look at cells I plus 1. That's the row number. Why do we look at I plus 1? Because if you remember, there are headings up in row 1. So point 1 is going to be in row 2. And the column is column 5. So that's column E. Get that value. Tony said he was going to have a select case in there. So we look at you know, if it's red or blue or green, then here's that line of code. So ser.pointsi.format.fill.forColor.rgb, all of that came from the recorded macro, is equal to, and I use the RGB function because I can figure out the RGB code. So red is just 255 in the red parameter. Blue is 255 in the blue parameter. Green, 255. Now, these are kind of ugly colors, especially the green. You can go get your own RGB mix of codes and put them in there. And then I also said, hey, let's go ahead and label the point with the value from column A. So ser.pointsi.datalabel.text. How did I figure this out? I turned on the macro recorder, added labels, selected one label, and changed it to something else just to see that it was .datalabel.text. All right, so here, let's take a look. Here's our chart right now. Here are the colors we want to use. We run this macro. And we now have the colors based on the colors here. And if later on we would change to a different color, we just have to come back and rerun the macro to reapply those colors. All right, well, hey, I want to thank Tony for sending that great question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.